morning with you all.
好，大家好，我是Stephen，我是我们母会的实习牧师。我今天很高兴和大家一起分享神的话语。
Have you ever bought a fixer-upper, a house that you knew was going to need a lot of work? And did you find that it took considerably more work than you expected? And what happened as your other priorities fell to the wayside as this project was underway? Did you find yourself neglecting important things such as family, work, and education while your house was being rebuilt?
你有没有买过那种烂房子，就是那种非常要经常修补的，要大修特修的那种？您是不是发现要修的永远比你想象的要多？在修房子期间，你怎么来处理其他重要的事情呢？在修房子期间，您是不是会发现你已经忽略了你自己的家庭、工作以及其他教育等其他重要的事情呢？
All kinds of things can turn our priorities upside down. Just daily life is enough to get us sidetracked. And as we open our Bibles to the book of Haggai, imagine a country where every house is a fixer-upper and every household is in disarray.
有任何事情的话，都会让我们舍本逐末。仅仅日常的琐碎的事情的话，就能让我们转移我们的注意力。当我们打开哈该书的时候的话，你可以想象一下，整个国家都是一个，每一所房子都是要到修理的，要不停的修理，家家户户都一片混乱。
The book of Haggai, the second shortest in the Old Testament, so if you're having trouble finding it, it's okay. You can miss it in a blink, but it has a powerful message. It tells us to put first things first in our lives. It was written to people like us who have told you that God must be first. You know, they believe that, and we believe that.
哈该书的话是在旧约中最短的，第二短的书。如果是您找不到的话，那是有可能的。它传达了一个强而有力的信息。它告诉我们，生活中最重要的事情是要得放在首位上。这本书的话是写给像我们这样的人，他们会告诉你，神必须要放在首位。他们相信，我们也相信。
But they had drifted. They gave lip service to the priority of God, but in fact, they lived with other priorities. God sent this prophet to help his people get their priorities in line with what they knew they should be.
但他们却迷失了方向。他们口头上说神是非常重要的，但是实际上他们的生活的重心已经偏向了别处。神派了这个先知来帮助他们的人民，将他们的优先事项的话，和他们所知道的事项重回一致。
The historical setting is early in the chapters of Ezra. In 536 BC, a remnant of about 50,000 Jews had returned from Babylon to Judah under the decree of Cyrus, the king of Persia. And they'd quickly rebuilt the altar and began offering sacrifices. But 2 years after returning, they had actually laid the foundation to rebuild the temple. And their Samaritan neighbors, they offered to join, but the Jews rejected the offer, and the Samaritans in turn threatened the workers and sent men to Persia to lobby against the Jews, and this brought the work to a halt.
我们来先谈一下这个历史的背景。以斯拉记在开头的章节，就是以斯拉记第五章，第一节就说了，在公元前536年时候，大约5万名犹太人，的渔民，根据波斯王居鲁士的命令，从巴比伦返回了犹大。那么他们在迅速地重建了祭坛，并且开始了献祭。返回了2年后，他们就奠定了重建祭坛的根基。但是他们的邻居撒玛利亚人，提出要加入这项工作，一起跟犹太人合作。但是犹太人拒绝了他们的提议。撒玛利亚人他们反过来就威胁他们的工人，并派人到波斯去贿赂，并反对犹太人建这个工作，所以这项工作呢就停止了。
Now, at least 14 years had passed, and the people got caught up in the routine of life, farming, building houses, raising families, that sort of thing, and they got used to life without a temple. Even their leaders, Zerubbabel, the governor, and Joshua, the high priest, they had gotten used to things as they were.
就这样，一下子14年过去了，人们的生活就步入了一个循环，一个轨道，那就是从务农 建造家庭，建造房屋，养家糊口，诸如此类的事情。他们已经习惯了没有圣殿的生活，就连他们的领袖总督所罗巴伯的和大祭司约书亚，他们也习惯了这样的情况。
Now God raised up Haggai and 2 months later Zechariah to proclaim his message to this returned remnant.
然而神兴起了哈该，并且在两个月后也兴起了撒加利亚，向归回的渔民来宣告他的信息。
There are four messages in the book of Haggai, and this morning we're going to look at the first message in chapter 1, verses 1 to 15. And you'll notice this isn't as much a message of judgment. It's actually more of a diagnosis. There's three parts. The Lord is going to challenge them in verses 1 to 6, and then give them a command in verses 7 to 11. And then we'll see the people's response and the Lord's blessing in verses 12 to 15.
哈该书的话有四个信息，今天早上的话我们能够学习一章一到十五节中的第一个信息。你会注意到这与其他的，与其说是审判的信息，不如说是诊断的信息。它有三个部分，主将在第一节到第六节中向他们发出了挑战，在第七到十一节中给他们下达了命令，然后的话他们将在第十二到十五节中看到了人民的回应以及主的祝福。
So if you're able, please stand for the reading of God's word, Haggai.
如果可以的话，请大家一起站立，我们来一起读那个哈该书一到十五章，第一章一节一到十五节。我们大家一起开始。大流士王第二年六月初一日，耶和华的话借先知哈该传给撒铁的儿子所罗巴伯和约萨达的儿子大祭司约书亚，说万军之耶和华说，这百姓说建造圣殿尚未来到。那是殿仍然荒凉，岂是你们做天花板房屋的时候呢？现在万军之耶和华如此说，你们要审查自己的行为，让工钱装在房中。万军之耶和华如此说，你们要审查自己的行为，你们要上山取木料建造这殿，我就因此喜悦接受荣耀，这是耶和华说的。你们盼望的所得的却少，你们收到家中就要出去，这是为什么呢？因为我的殿荒凉，你们个人却顾自己的房屋，这是万军之耶和华说的。所以为你们的缘故，天就不降甘露，地也不出产，我命干旱临到地土，山冈、五谷、新酒和油，并地上的蔬产、人民牲畜以及人手一切的劳碌来的。那时撒拉铁的儿子所罗巴伯和约萨达的儿子大祭司约书亚，并剩下的百姓都听从耶和华他们的神的话，和先知阿该奉耶和华他们神差来所撒的话，百姓也在耶和华面前存敬畏的心。耶和华的使者哈该奉耶和华差遣和百姓说，耶和华说，我与你们同在。耶和华激动犹大省儿子所罗巴伯和约萨达的儿子大祭司约书亚，并剩下之百姓的心，他们就来为万军之耶和华他们的神的殿做工。这是在大乌利王第二年六月二十四日。好，请大家坐下。
Let's keep our Bibles open as we study God's word together.
让我们一起来学神的话语。
To sum up the first message, God will grant true blessing when we put his house first.
我们总结一下第一个信息，就是当我们把神的家放在第一位的时候，神会就给予我们真正的祝福。
In short, give God the primary place in your life. Or as Jesus put it in Matthew 6:33, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you.
简而言之，让神在你的生活中占据首位，或者正如耶稣在马太福音中所说的那样，马太福音六章第三十三节说，你们要先求他的国和他的义，这些东西就会加给你们的。
We all know this, but we're inclined to place our prosperity above God's house.
我们都知道这一点，但是我们却倾向于把我们能够过上好日子凌驾于神的家之上。
It's our nature. It's in our DNA. If we give no thought to how we're living, we will naturally live for our agendas and not for God's.
这就是我们的天性，这是我们的 DNA。如果我们从不考虑我们该如何活，我们的天性就会按着自己的意愿去活，而不是按照神的意愿去活。
May all of us who have trusted in Christ as Savior, they know intellectually that it's foolish to live for things of this world. And we know that these things will never deliver the satisfaction that they promise. We know that we won't find true happiness apart from God. And yet, we are drifting and keep drifting towards loving the world. And if we don't fight against it, it will happen, even as committed believers.
我们这所有的相信基督是我们救主的人，理智上的话我们都是知道了，为世间之物而活是愚蠢和徒劳的。我们也知道这些东西的话不会给我们带来终极的满足，我们也知道离开神我们不会找到真正的祝福和快乐。然而我们如果不是时常征战的话，我们就不自觉地去慢慢地去爱上这个世界，即使我们是坚定的基督徒也是这个样子。
In order to understand Haggai's message, we can't forget he's speaking to the very people who made the difficult commitment to leave their established way of life in Babylon and make a dangerous journey back to the promised land. They had homes and jobs in Babylon. Most of them had been born and raised there, but they knew that God's purpose was for his people to be involved in the promised land. So by faith, they had responded to the call to return and had committed themselves to the hardships of getting reestablished in the land that had been destroyed by war. And most of them probably made that decision because of their commitment to God.
So, 为了理解哈该的信息，我们就不能够忘记，哈该他对他说话的群众，其实是那些他们好不容易做出了非常艰难的决定，离开了他们在巴比伦的舒适的生活，踏上了那个危险的旅程，并返回应许之地的那些人。他们在巴比伦的话是有家也有工作，他们中间大部分人说不定都是在那个地方出生和在那儿长大的，但他们知道神对他的子民的旨意和应许之地是有非常关系的，所以凭着信念，他们响应了回归的呼召，并决定在被那些战争摧毁的土地上重新定居下来，克服困难。他们中的大部分人可能都是因为对神的忠诚而做出了这些承诺。
They returned and tried to rebuild the temple. They faced opposition, they stopped, and gradually they lost their vision and they drifted into a lifestyle where God's house was no longer the priority. They probably viewed it as nice, but not necessary. Extra, but not essential.
他们返回并试图重建圣殿，他们被抗议反对，所以停下了他们的工程。渐渐的，他们失去了意向，陷入了一种不再以神的家为优先的生活方式。他们可能认为有圣殿也很好，但不是必要的，不是那个所必须的。
And isn't this the case today? I mean, if you know Christ, there was a time in your life when you made a personal commitment to him. And at first you were hungry for spiritual things. You were in the word daily. Maybe you were involved with groups like Navigators, serving in church. But then you faced some difficulties. You had a personality clash with another Christian. You were disillusioned by the disappointing results. Or you encountered personal trials that God didn't remove, even after much prayer.
而如今话又如常不是这个样子呢？如果你认识基督，曾经有一段时间的话，你对他所做出了个人的承诺， 起初的时候，你非常渴望圣灵，属灵上的事情，每天在读圣经，也参加了一些教会，教会的施工以及教会的团体组织，在教会里的话有服侍，但后来的话遇到了一些困难，或者你与一些基督徒的基督徒发生了一些冲突，或者你对教会感到了失望，或者你做了很多的祷告，但是神没有给你的帮助和回应，你就感觉到一些失望。
Meanwhile, life moved on. You started a career and a family. You had bills to pay and other demands on your time, and church and the Lord's work drifted into the background. You still attend church as often as you can, but it becomes a slice of life and not the center.
与此同时的话，生活还要继续。你开始了事业和你的家庭，你有账单需要付，还有一些别的事情也占据了你的时间。教会和主渐渐的退居幕后，你仍然尽可能会去经常的去教会，但是它已经成为了你生活的一部分，而不是叫你的生活的中心。
You may tell yourself that you just don't have the time to serve, not like you used to, and someone else who doesn't have the responsibilities that you have will get involved. And without deliberately rebelling, against God, you've drifted into putting your house above God's house. When your conscience nags, you have reasons to explain why things are this way.
你会告诉你自己，你只是没有时间像以前那样服侍主了。有些人的话该站出来服侍了，他们平时的话也没有负很多责任和负担。你并没有刻意的去反抗神，反而把你的家放在神的家之上。当你的良心不安时，你有理由去解释为什么会事情会发生这个样子。
Look at verse 2, they were saying, the time has not come even for the house of the Lord to be rebuilt.
看看第二节，他们说时候尚未到，甚至不是重建耶和华殿的时候。
If you would ask them why the temple had not have been built, they would have responded something like, you know, don't get me wrong, I'm all for rebuilding the temple. It's a great cause. I have the sticker on my car, rebuild the temple. But it's not a great time for us right now. The economy is getting hit pretty hard. Everyone's pinched for money. There aren't enough good jobs going around. It's all I can do to provide for my family, but times will get better. And then we'll rebuild the temple.
如果你问他们为什么不重新在圣殿没有重新建成呢？他们会回答你，哦，别误会，我不是这个意思，我完全赞成要重建的圣殿，这是一个非常伟大的事件，而且我在我的车上面贴了重建圣殿的标签贴纸，但是现在我们来说的话，这不是一个好时机，也不是一个好时候。经济受到严重的打击，每个人都很缺钱，每个人都没有好的工作，我们只是能够养家糊口，但是事情总会变好起来的，到那个时候我们就重新建殿。
And how often is that true for us today? That we're all prone to make up excuses for why we're not obedient to put God first with our time and our money that he entrusts us.
那么今天的我们有多少时候也是这个样子呢？神如此的信任我们，我们却不顺从他，不把时间和金钱第一的献给他，而编了一大堆的借口。
Now in verse 6, the people in Haggai's day were having problems. There's a shortage of life's necessities, little to harvest, dealing with drought. Inflation was like putting the little money they had left into bags with holes. And by the end of the month, there was nothing left. Of course, the hard times meant that they didn't have any extra to give towards a building fund. But surely God understood their difficult circumstances.
那我们来看呢，第六节中，看到哈该那个时代的人，他遇到了一些麻烦，生活的必需品又很短缺，收成的话也不多，干旱、通货膨胀也把他们的剩余的一些钱都放在了空洞的有带动的口袋里一样。到了月底的话，什么都不剩下， 当然，艰难的时期的话，就意味着他们没有钱来去捐献，来建圣殿。但神肯定是了解他们的这样的处境的。
What they didn't see was that God not only understood their circumstances, He caused them. They were working harder, but going behind even faster, and they had never stopped to consider that God was trying to tell them something.
可他们没有想到的是，这一切的处境其实神都了解，因为这是神造成了这一切，让这一切都发生了。他们更加的努力的去工作，却事倍功半，徒劳无获。但他们却始终停不下来，好好的想一想，神告诉了他们什么。
So Haggai came along and said, "Hey, folks, it's actually God who controls the rain and the harvest. He is withholding His blessing because your priorities are not right. Put His house first, and He will bless you. Seek first His kingdom, and all these things will be added unto you."
所以哈该说，嘿，伙计们。是神控制着雨水和收成，没有他的祝福，因为你们的时间、你们的事情的顺序都不对了。把他的家放在首位，他就会把赐福给你们。先寻求他的国，所有的东西他都会加给你们。
It's the danger of putting their prosperity above God's kingdom. They've lost the spiritual perspective that they desperately need, and they're forgetting that if their ways are pleasing to the Lord, He will give them all that they need. They need to stop and consider that they are working against God, who in verse 9 tells us, merely blows on their take-home pay and scatters it. And He does this to get them to reconsider their mixed-up priorities.
将自己的祝福、财富的话置于神的国之上是很危险的。他们已经失去了他们迫切需要的属灵的看见，他们也忘记了，如果他们的行为让神喜悦，神就会赐予他们一切所需要的。他们需要停下来思考，他们是在与神作对。正如第九节告诉我们的是，神轻轻地吹，就把他们的收获给灰飞烟灭了。神这样的做是为了让他们好好的想一想他们颠倒错乱的优先顺序。
Instead, he says, they must deliberately and continually put God's house above their priorities.
所以反而他们应该做是必须坚持持之以恒的将神的殿的工作放在重中之重。
Let me clarify what I mean by God's house in our text. Of course, it refers to the Temple of Jerusalem, which was the center for worshiping God. And although God is everywhere, the temple was the place on earth where God dwelled in a special sense. He revealed His glory there.
让我澄清一下，神的殿到底是什么意思？当然，我们在经文中的话，它指的是耶路撒冷的圣殿，那是敬拜神的中心。虽然神无处不在，但圣殿是神在地球上居住的特殊的地方，他在那里彰显他的荣耀。
The sacrifices that were offered there pointed ahead to the coming of God's Messiah, Jesus, who would offer himself as God's final and complete sacrifice for our sins.
那里所献的祭品预示着弥赛亚耶稣的到来，他献出自己为我们的罪向神献上最完美的赎罪祭。
To allow the temple to lay in ruins was to neglect the worship of God. And today, on this side of the cross, God's temple isn't in a physical building, but rather it's His people, individually and corporately.
当圣殿成为了废墟，就是忽视对神的崇拜。但今天借着十字架，神的圣殿不再是一座实体的建筑，而是他们的子民。
To make God's house the priority in life means that your number one aim is to make your body a fit dwelling for the Holy Spirit and to devote yourself to building others in Christ so that their lives are a proper dwelling for the Holy Spirit.
让神的殿成为你生命的重中之重，就意味着你的首要目的 是要将你的身体成为圣灵所适合的居所，并致力于在基督里建造他人，使他们的生命成为神所合适的居所。
So the idea is that by faith, to know Christ personally and to do all that you can so that you can help others to do the same.
这需要我们凭着信心亲自的认识基督，并尽力所能的去帮助其他人，也同样做到这一点。
And as we mentioned, we're naturally inclined to put material prosperity above spiritual prosperity, and that's the current of the world that we have to fight against.
正如我们所提到的是，我们的天性是爱物质过于注重我们的属灵的生活，这就是我们必须要与世界对抗。
What's interesting is the contrast between Haggai and the other prophets like Isaiah or Jeremiah, I mean, who preached all their lives to stubborn and disobedient people. Haggai preached and the people obeyed.
有趣的是，哈该和与以赛亚、耶利米的其他先知相比的话，他们的一生都是向那些顽固悖逆的人们传道，但是哈该的宣讲，人们就听了。
And it started with the leaders in verse 12, Zerubbabel and Joshua, and that took humility. They're political and spiritual leaders.
那么事情化始于第十二节中的领袖所罗巴伯和约书亚，这是让我们看到了他们的谦卑。他们因为他们是政治和精神上的领袖。
It would have been easy to resist Haggai's message. They would have wanted to preserve their reputation. I mean, who does this upstart prophet think he is? We've never heard of him before. He doesn't have any credentials, and he just comes along and says, "Thus says the Lord of hosts," and we're supposed to believe him?
他们想要保住自己的名声，其实应该很容易的去抵挡哈该的信息。他们可以告诉大家，这是一个自命不凡的先知，以为他是谁啊？我们以前从来没有听过他的名，他也没有任何的资历，他只不过来说万军之耶和华如此说，那我们就要信他了吗？
Yes, they were supposed to believe him, and thankfully they did, and that's an anomaly in the prophets.
然而他们应该相信，而且谢天谢地，他们真的确实的相信了，真的是非常非常的不容易。
And it's interesting, Haggai claims to speak the word of the Lord more than any of the other prophets, 25 times in 38 verses, and he refers to God as Lord of hosts 14 times.
有趣的是，哈该声称那自己比圣经中任何的其他的先知都要经常说出神的话语，一共在38节经文中共说了25次，并且的话他有14次将神称为万军之耶和华。
I mean, he's basically saying God is the Lord over all the armies of heaven and earth, and I'm bringing you his message, so you better listen up. And in this case, the people did listen and obey.
他说神是天地万军之主，我向你们传达他的信息，所以你们最好要听。在这种情况下，人们确实听从。
What we learn here is that we must accept the Bible as the authoritative word of the Lord of hosts and submit to it. That when it confronts the way we live, we can either resist by making up excuses or we can obey it.
我们在这里学到的是，我们必须要接受圣经作为万军之耶和华的权威的话语，并且顺服它。当它与我们的生活方式有相冲突的时候，我们要么通过编造更多的借口来抵挡它，要么就是要顺服它。
But one time obedience is not enough. We must deliberately and continually obey if we want to keep our priorities in order. And so how can we do that?
但是一次的顺服是不够的。如果我们要想把我们的优先事项安排的井井有条的话，我们必须要刻意的持之以恒的去顺服。那我们该怎么做呢？
Well, twice the Lord tells the people, consider your ways, both in verse 5 and verse 7, literally set your hearts.
主在第五节和第七节的话两次的去告诉百姓，你们要省察自己的行为。 的字面意思就是要立定你们的心。
The idea is to stop long enough in your busy schedule to evaluate your life in light of God's word and fearing Him.
这个想法是在你繁忙的日程中要停下来，有足够长的时间，根据神的话语和敬畏他的心来评估你的生活。
And how are you spending your time? These people had plenty of time for themselves, but they didn't have time for God.
你是如何去度过你的时间的话，这些人的话，他们有充足的时间给自己，但是他们就是没有时间给神。
I mean, what do you think about most? What secretly occupies your thought life? Do you dream of getting rich or achieving fame or some hobby or leisure pursuit? Or do you think about the Lord and how He wants you to spend His life?
那你常常想的是什么呢？你的心思意念的话，有被什么不可告人的事情占据吗？你梦想了致富、成名，从事某些爱好和休闲的活动，还是你在思考主想要你如何度过你的一生，如何去度过你休闲的时间
？I mean, how do you spend your leisure time when you have time off? How do you spend it? Do you watch TV or do you live for sports? Do you hang out with friends? How does your time reflect your and affect your devotion to Christ?
那你如何去度过你的休闲的生活呢？当你有空的时候，你是如何去度过呢？你去看电视，你沉迷于一些活动，你和朋友一起出去玩，你的时间话如何反映和影响你对基督的委身呢？
I mean, how are you spending your money, which is really God's money? They claim that they had to get their own houses built first, and then they would build God's house. And that was backwards. We are all managers of all that He has given us and to invest it profitably for His kingdom.
你是如何花你的钱呢？这些钱是其实是神的钱。他们声称他们必须要得先建好自己的房子，然后才能建神的殿。这是本末倒置的。我们是神产业的管家，我们的一切都是神赐的，应该投资在神的国里。
So undergirding all of these questions should be the fear of God, as verse 12 says that the people feared the Lord.
所有的这些问题的话，基础就是应该要敬畏神，或是害怕敬畏神。在第十二节说，百姓敬畏耶和华。
Now some people think the Old Testament is all about fear of the Lord and the New Testament is all about the love that God gives, but that's not the case. The New Testament has plenty of references for fearing God and fear of the Lord.
那么有些人就认为的话，旧约的话一般都说的是要畏惧敬畏神，而新约的话都说的是要对神的爱。但是的话其实并不是如此的，在新约中的话也有很多地方描述了是要对神的敬畏。
Well, we don't need to fear His final judgment. If we're in Christ, we should reverently obey God. And if the question's why, well, it's because God will grant true blessing when we put His house first.
那么如果我们信奉神的话，那我们就无需去具备他最后的终极的审判，但我们应该虔诚的去侍奉神。为什么呢？因为当我们把神的家放在首位的话，神会赐福于我们真正的祝福。
God is looking for pleasure and glory from His people. The main problem when we fail to put His house first is that we're indifferent to His glory. Our aim should be God's glory.
那么神正在寻找从他子民来的喜悦和荣耀。当我们未能将神的家放在首位时，主要的问题是我们对神的荣耀漠不关心，我们的目的应该是神的荣耀。
The Lord, as we see, stirred up the hearts of the leaders and the people in verse 14, and it says, and they came and worked in the house of the Lord of hosts, their God. So while we're responsible to get our priorities in order, when we do it, it's because God has actually moved in our hearts.
在第十四节中，主激动了领袖和百姓的心，说他们就来为万军之耶和华他们的神的他们神的殿做工。虽然我们有责任把事情的轻重缓急按的顺序排好， 但当我们这样做的时候，那时因为神已经在我们的心中动工了。
And when the people obeyed, God sent word in verse 13, I'm with you. And to that I say, if God seems distant in your life, perhaps your priorities have gotten mixed up. When you put God truly first in your life, you experience a new awareness of his presence, and that is true blessing.
当人们顺服时，神在第13节中就发出声音，我与你们同在。如果神似乎远离你，那么也许是你的优先事项已经混乱了。当你真正的把神放在首位时，你会体验到对他存在的全新的认识，这才是真正的祝福。
So as I conclude, there's a story of a time management expert who's speaking to a group of business students, and he pulled out a large, wide mouth jar, and he filled it with fist-sized rocks. And when he couldn't put any more in, he asked the students, "Is the jar full?"
那么在快到结论的时候，我想用一个比喻，一个故事来做一个总结。有个关于有一个时间管理方面的一个专家，他向一群商学院的学生演讲的时候，他拿出了一个很大口的一个罐子，然后呢就在罐子里面装了很多拳头大小的石头。当他无法再放下那些石头的时候，他会问他的学生，这个罐子已经满了吗？
And so the class responded, yeah. And he said, really? And then he pulled out a bucket of gravel and he poured it in and started shaking it down through the cracks. Then he asked, is the jar full?
那么全班同学就说，是的。他说，真的吗？然后呢，他就拿出了一桶碎石，然后倒了进去，从裂缝中抖了抖。然后的话，他就问，罐子满了吗？
So now the students were on to him. They said, no. And he said, good. He replied and he dumped in a bucket of sand. And once more he asked,Is the jar full? And now they're shouting, no. And again, he said, good. And he poured a pitcher of water into the jar until it was filled to the brim.
那么现在的话，学生都明白了。于是的话，他们说，没有，很好。他回答说，然后他就倒了一桶沙子。然后他再问，罐子满了吗？没有。学生们回道，他再说很好，然后他又倒了一壶水，再一直到罐子满到了边缘。
Then he asks, you know, what is the point of this illustration? And one student ventured, no matter how full your schedule, if you try hard, you can always fit more in.
然后他就问了，那么我做这些东西是表示什么意思呢？那么一个大学生的话，大胆的回答说，无论你的日程安排有多么的满，只要你努力，你总是能够挤出一点更多的时间。
The speaker replied, no, that's not the point. I sympathize with the student. But the point is, if you don't put the big rocks in first, you'll never get them in at all.
那么讲员就说，不，这不是重点，重点是如果你不把大石头放进去，那么你以后就永远不可能再把它放进去了。
What should your big rocks be? It should be God and his house, the things of the kingdom. Put them into your life first.
那你的大石头应该是什么呢？应该是神，神和他的殿。把神的殿放在你的首位吧。